Assuming that critical block VC of a viscous liquid flowing through a capillary tube depends upon radius r the tube, density rho, and coefficient of viscosity eta of the liquid, use method of dimensions to obtain a relationship between these quantities. So we write as VC, critical velocity, is proportional to r to the power a, rho to the power b, eta refers to, where r is radius of, where VC is critical velocity, r is the radius of the capillary tube, rho is the density, eta is coefficient of viscosity. How they are dependent, we have written as a, b, and c, and we are going to find out the values of a, b, and c. First of all, we write the dimension formula for these quantities. VC is critical velocity, is basically velocity only. This is upon time or displacement upon time, it is L by T. So it is dimensional formula for critical velocity is same, that of velocity, that is L1T minus 1. Going to density, density we know, mass upon volume. Volume is what? Length into breadth into height. So all these dimensions, they are of length only. So M upon L3, so M1, L minus 3 is the dimensional formula for density. Coming to coefficient of viscosity eta, we know we have a Stokes law, F is equal to 6 pi eta rV, where a body of radius r is moving through a liquid, or rather a fluid of coefficient of viscosity eta, then it experiences drag force, which is given by F is equal to 6 pi eta rV, where r is the radius of that sphere, v is the velocity, eta is coefficient of viscosity, and F is the drag force. So eta is equal to F upon 6 pi rV. F is mass into acceleration upon 6 pi rV. Mass into acceleration, mass m. Acceleration's dimensional formula is L1T minus 2. 6 pi is constant, it goes off. R is L only, is basically length only. Velocity L1T minus 1. So we get the dimensional formula for coefficient of viscosity as M1 L minus 1 T minus 1. We put the dimensional formula for these quantities over here, VC, R, rho, and eta, when we put over here, we get this expression. You open the brackets, we get LA, MB, L minus 3B, MC, L minus C, C minus 1 into C is minus C. Then what we do is, we segregate from here in terms of M, L, and T. I start from here, MB, MC, so B plus C, LA, minus 3B, minus C, then going to T. T is only, we have only one term, T to the power minus C. On this side, we have M0 L1 T minus 1. So because of principle of homogeneity, the dimensions of MLT over here and over here, that should be same. On LHS and RHS, the dimensions of ML and T, that should be same. So that's why we equate the powers of ML and T on this side with this side. So power of M over here, the dimension of M over here is 0. Dimension of M over here is B plus C, so 0 is equal to B plus C. Similarly for L, L over here is 1, over here A minus 3B minus C, so 1 is equal to A minus 3B minus C. Similarly for T, it's minus 1 over here, so minus 1 is equal to minus C, so that's why we get C is equal to 1. As soon as we get C is equal to 1, put it over here, so B is going to be minus 1. We've got B is equal to minus 1, C is equal to 1. Put these values in this equation. 1 is equal to A minus 3 into minus 1, B is minus 1, minus C is 1, we put it over here, so we get A is equal to minus 1. So, we have got the values of A also, B also, C also, put this value in this equation and we have the requisite expression. So, VC is directly proportional to R bar A is what? A is minus 1, root of R B, B is what? Minus 1. Eta is for C, C is what? 1. So, R and rho go to the denominator. So, it is VC is critical velocity is proportional to eta upon R, rho is the required expression.